Hi everyone, in this video I want to show you another spectacular game played by young FIDE master Călu Mircea and grandmaster Marius Manolache from Romania. These two players meet again 11 months ago in Romania's Open from Alba Iulia, when Mircea managed to crush his opponent using one of his favorites, opening the Nimzo Indian defense. If you want to watch that game, I'll leave a link into the description. Today's game was played in the 13th Arad International Chess Festival, round 8. The game that I'll show you today is very instructive because Mircea applied correct plans in all phases of the game. He accumulated stable positional advantages, then his opponent pushed the game into the endgame, which was not good, allowing white to win. The difference elo between the two players is around 200 elo points. Let's see the game. Mircea started with d4, knight to f6, c4, g6, and with this move, Marius wants to develop his bishop on the long diagonal, and he might play d6, the king's Indian defense, or d5, the Grunfeld defense. Mircea continued with g3. This is the third move played in this position, but it's a valid one because it prepares the development of the bishop. As you know, in the opening, pawn moves are good only if they allow us to develop a piece. The most popular moves here are knight to c3 and knight to f3, bishop to g7, bishop to g2, d6, and we have the king's Indian defense. Knight to c3, short castle, knight to f3, knight to c6, provoking white to push the pawn forward. But Mircea continues with castle, and with this move he completed the second step of his opening plan. He only needs to connect the rooks by moving the queen, and his opening is done. a6. This is known as the panel variation of the king's Indian defense. d5. Good move, gaining space, forcing black to move his developed piece. Knight to e5, b3, defending the pawn. Another way was to defend it with the knight, but this is also good. It also prepares the development of the bishop. c5, the queen diagonal is open, and white took en passant. B takes on c6, and in this moment, black has an isolated pawn on a6. We need to take a mental note about this first weakness of our opponent. The game continued with bishop to b2, developing the last minor piece, rook to b1, moving the rook away from the diagonal, and also the rook is well placed on the open file. Queen to d2, and with this move, Mircea finished his opening and we are entering the middle game. And the plan in this phase of the game is to start an attack, which is composed of two steps. One, find the opponent weaknesses, which are weak squares, backward pawns, isolated and advanced pawn from the fifth and from the sixth rank. And the second step is to involve all our pieces into the attack. This plan has to be updated every time we have a change in pawn structure and material. In this position, as we mentioned, black has an isolated pawn on a6, but it's hard to attack it. So what can we do? In this situation, the general rule is to apply the principle of the least active piece, improve the activity of your pieces, or decrease the opponent's activity. White needs to bring his rooks into the game and push pawns. So white can continue with rook a to d1, rook f to e1, and push the pawn to e4, e5. Let's see the game continuation, where Marius pushed c5. This pawn move has several roles. It creates a retreat square for the knight on c6. It also opens the diagonal for the bishop. But from white's point of view, the pawn structure has changed, and d5 became a weak square. Of course, black can play e6, but in this case, d6 will become weak. White plans needs to change a bit. Now he can place a knight on d5, but first he needs to bring all his pieces into the game. So we had rook a to d1, bishop to b7, rook f to e1, all pieces are ready for the fight. Marius played queen to b6, connecting his rooks, and his opening is done. And here Mircea pushed e4. As we can see, the light square bishop is locked by this pawn, and the next knight to d5 will follow. Rook f to d8, knight to d5, attacking the queen, and black took with the bishop, which was a bad piece in this moment. If white takes with the pawn, black has a tactical shot with knight takes on c4, and if white takes, black will regain the piece. It seems the position is equal, but black bishop is more active. In the game, Mircea took first on f6 with the bishop. Black recapture with the pawn. He opened the e-file, but we have a backward on d6. And this is the second weakness of the game. The first one is the isolated pawn from a6. Our purpose in chess game is to collect stable positional advantages, which are weaknesses in pawn structure and material, and when we have sufficient stable advantages, we can transfer the game into the end game. And for this, we need to exchange pieces. Also, if the number of weaknesses in opponent camp is greater than the number of pieces, it would be very hard for him to defend. Let's return to our game, where knight to b7 was played, trying to improve the knight activity, but it doesn't have any good square to go. Another way was to play f5 and open the bishop. In this position, white needs to start an attack. And for this, he needs to push pawns, make contact with opponent pawns, and exchange them. So he can push g4, h4. Also, white bishop is locked, so we can improve it by moving it to another diagonal. Why continue with queen to d3, queen to a5? Better was to activate the bishop. h4. Black cannot take the pawn from a2 because after rook to a1, the queen is lost. So he continued with h5, bishop to h3, rook to e8. Now black is threatening to take on e1 and then take the pawn from a2. So white defended the pawn and he will want to double on the e-file. Black pushed f5. The bishop is free, but it doesn't have any target in this moment. Rook d to e1, threatening to win the rook. And in this position, we need to see what are black options. The first one is to take the rook, and after this, white will recapture. Bishop takes on f5. If black exchanges queens, white will have an extra pawn. So black will take the bishop. Queen to c1, check. King to g2, queen to h6, defending h5, but white queen can infiltrate on the 7th rank, and she will want to go to c7, and she will win some material. Queen to f6, trying to defend the rook with queen to d8, but after knight to g5, the queen is overloaded. She cannot defend the rook or this pawn. So this option is not good for black. In the game, he tried to defend the rook with the king. White needs to attack, and we know the first way how to do it. Push pawns, make contact and exchange them. And the second way is to do a positional sacrifice. Before doing a sacrifice, we need to calculate to see if it's working or not. Mircea saw that the sacrifice is working, giving a piece for two pawns, but in the same time he will destroy black defense around his king, and he will also have access to the 7th rank. And after this move, he sacrificed the bishop. First, he took on e2, rook takes on e2. Here, Marius saw that taking on f5 is not that good, so he played queen to c3. I'm surprised about this move. Marius wants to enter the endgame in a worse position. He already has two weaknesses. Mircea gladly accepted this, and we enter the endgame. In this endgame, the plan is different, and it's composed of two steps. First, attack opponent weak pawns, and the second one is to push your passed pawns. In this position, white has an extra pawn and two weak pawns, the one from a6 and d6. Here he can apply only the first step, so he needs to attack these weaknesses. Black only counter chance is to push his isolated pawn and try to ruin white pawn structure, but white saw this and prevented this move with bishop to d7. Now the bishop is covering this diagonal. Bishop to f6. Black has no counter chance, while white plan is very simple. Another important idea in the endgame is to bring the king into the game by centralize it, attack opponent pawns, and help your pawns to go forward and promote. Also, a good idea when we bring the game into the game is to do it under the protection of another piece. Mircea continued with king to g2, rook to d8, bishop to c6, attacking the knight, knight to a5, bishop to a4, rook to b8, knight to g5, bishop to d4. Black is shuffling the pieces, but Mircea's plan is simple. He advanced the pawn, king to f3, rook to b8, g4, g takes, king takes on g4, and now white can create a passed pawn with f5, and if black will take, he will have a passed pawn on the h-file. Knight to b7, bishop to c6, knight to a5, bishop to d7, rook to d8, bishop to a4, knight to b7, f5, g takes on e5, king takes on a5, and in this moment white has a passed pawn, and he can start pushing it every time his opponent allows it. Also, black has three weaknesses in this position: a6, d6, and f7. Also, black has to take care of white a passed pawn, so his defense is really stretched. If white manages to exchange one more piece, black defense will collapse. This position is definitely winning for white. In the game we had bishop to e5. Black has no threat, so he can push the pawn. Instead he played knight to f3, attacking the bishop, bishop to c3. White needs to push the pawn with h5. If the king comes toward the pawn, we will have rook to e7, attacking the knight, defending the knight, knight to g5, attacking the pawn, knight to d8, defending for a second time. Rook to e8, pinning the knight, bishop to f5, defending the knight, b4, c takes on b4, h6, king takes, deflecting the king away from the defense of the pawn, king to f6. Black cannot prevent mate without losing material. In the game, king to g2 was played. And here, black continue with king to e7, rook to e2, check, king to f8, h5. Finally, the pawn is pushed, h6, good move, rook to d8, black is paralyzed, he cannot do anything, rook to g2, king to e7, rook to e2, check, they repeated moves, maybe they were in time trouble, king to f8, king to g2, king to e7, h7, finally, the pawn is one square until it will become a queen, rook to h8, rook to g8, black cannot take on h7 due to rook to e8 mate. So knight to d8. And what can white do here? The first thought should be to attack. And if there are no attacking moves, he needs to improve the activity of his pieces. Let's look at all his pieces. With the rook, there is no logical move. With the bishop, he can try to place it on c6, provoking black to take this bishop and create a passed pawn on c6, and that pawn will become a queen very soon. With the knight, he can try to go to g5 or h4. In the game, he opted for knight to g5, a5, knight to e4, bishop to d4, knight to f2. The bishop cannot take the knight because the rook will be lost. So bishop to e4, knight to d3, bishop to d4, knight to e1. White will try to go on the other side of the board trying to attack this a5 pawn. Bishop to e5, knight to c2, bishop to c3, knight to e3, bishop to e5, bishop to c6. Finally, he tries to see what black is doing here, and this is a big mistake from black part, because this pawn will promote very soon. In this moment, the pawn is free to take, so black takes on h7, c7. Black cannot prevent white from queening, so he tried rook to h4, queen, rook to h5, king to g4, rook to h4, check. Black is lost, and after a few moves he will get mated. But in the game he played a careless move and he gave check with the rook on e8, and now he promoted to a queen. But white is winning anyhow. The game lasted another 30 moves, but we don't need to look at the converting technique, so we can go faster here. After this move, we had king to e7, queen to c7, check, king to e8, knight to b5. The queen alone cannot win. Another important aspect that I need to mention here is that the queen works very well with a knight. A queen with a bishop don't work that well. The bishop works very well with a rook. Rook to h5, check, king to g4, rook to h6, queen to c8, check, king to e7, knight to c7, king to f6, knight to e8, check, king to e7, knight to c7, king to f6, king to f3, rook to h2, queen to d8, check, king to f8, queen to d7, check, king to g6, queen to g4, check, king to a6. There were a lot of checks. Black takes a pawn, knight to e7, rook to h2, queen to g8, rook to h3, check, king to e4, rook to h4, white king will try to escape black checks, rook to d4, check, king to g6, rook to f4, queen to f8, check, king to g5, queen to g8, king to h4, king to b5, rook to f3, king to a4, defending the pawn, king to h3, queen to h7, check, king to g3, knight to f5, check, king to f2, queen to f7, white wins another pawn, king to e1, queen to d5. The knight cannot be touched due to queen to e4, check, winning the rook. So we had a rook to f2, knight takes on d6, winning another pawn, bishop to d4, knight to e4, rook to a2, check, king to b5, rook to b2, attacking this pawn. But after knight takes on c5, Marius resigned. The game looked simple, but Mircea's understanding is very simple and clear. His opponent made a lot of mistakes, allowing him to collect several stable positional advantages in the middle game, and in the end game he stretched opponent defense and he collapsed very quickly. If Mircea will play like this in the future, he will definitely reach the GM title very soon. At the end of the tournament, Mircea had 7 points after 9, same number of points with the players from position 1, 2 and 3. So it was a good tournament for Mircea. Congratulations to him, and this was the game that I wanted to show you today. If you found this video useful, click on the like button, share this video, watch other games from my channel, and leave some comments and suggestions in the comment section. See you next time. Bye.